No, io no. Vabbè, io perché ho qualche problema direttamente da qui. No, perché l'ho già provato. Perché se lui lancia lui non trova questo, c'ha ragione che non lo trova.
Ma non trova il percorso?
Però io l'ho installato.
Quindi c'è un errore diverso. A posto
Okay, let's have a look now to the simulation number 3, and you see that the acronym, the name of the simulation file is PS, which stands for particle swarm, for the experimental variogram and theoretical variogram. So what we are going to do here is to receive a name for the theoretical variogram. So you can see now there is linear, but then you can put whatever type of semivariogram you want to fit through your data. And then there are some other variables that we introduce here just for make things easier. For example, the variable that we are going to fit the semivariogram for. In this case, we will run the precipitation. In the afternoon, you will run also the temperature. And then the name of the period we are fitting the variogram for. You remember with Niccolò, you just computed two types of mean semivariogram, one for the entire simulation period, and you name it like total, and one for each season, and you name it like season. In this case, we will run the total one for precipitation. So we just put instead of season total, and you can even save it. here, and then the data. But the first thing you should know is that this is not a normal SIM file. This is a special SIM file. Because our SIM file won't start. The SIM file you have seen up to now won't start with this PS. If we look at the second one, for example, it starts like OMS3.sim. So it declares that it is just a simulation file. The third one, the one we were speaking about, is not a SIM file, but is a OMS3.particles one. So this is the first main difference. And this is the string that defines that we are not running a simulation file, but we are running an optimization, and the optimization type is particles one. If we will run Luca during the next day, we will find a Luca running. Okay? So this is to define that we are running not just a common simulation file, but a simulation file, but a specific particle swarm simulation. So for particle swarm, this morning we specified most of the ingredients, and then this type of simulation file, which is a PS underscore run, will take different parts. The first part you can already see here is the model. In fact, the next string is the model. And this is exactly the SIM file of the model that you want to calibrate. And this is exactly what we ran before. The model that we want to calibrate is a theoretical variable. And so here, you can even copy and paste, we already did it for you, the simulation file that you specify in the number 2 simulation file, in the theoretical variable. So it's just the model that you want to calibrate. It starts from here, and you see, as each model has the parameters in which we make the connection of different components, and it ends here. Then there are some parameters you have to specify, and those parameters are parameters specific of the particle swarm or of the calibration algorithm you are running. For example, here you specify the maximum number of iterations, which is 5,000, the number of particles, which are the fishermen of the example. So how many particles we want to run to explore our parameter space. And then there are specific parameters for the stopping criteria. For example, check after, it means after how many simulation we want to, or iteration, we want to start to check about the tolerance. So about the stopping criteria we want to execute. So it's like the first 175 simulations are done for exploring the parameter set, and then after the 175 we start to see have we reached the stopping criteria or not. Then we specify among the 175 how many iterations we want to consider in our stopper criteria, and then we find the minimum number of iterations we want to perform. And what is the stopping criteria? It's specified in the delta, check delta. So this delta is the improvement of our fitness between two iterations. So the idea here is that after 175 iterations of the particles. If we find an improvement of our objective function that is less than 1 to 10 to minus 8, then we can stop. We are sure that we are not improving anymore to continue to explore our parameters. Then there is the verbose, which is the each programmer usually put this flag, is the amount of information we want to print in your console in order to see if everything is going well or we have some error. So if you put verbose 1, you have just written here a few iteration, like few information about what is the iteration that is running currently and so on. If you put verbose 2, you will print also out the model results, for example, for each iteration, and stuff to check and to see if we are converging or not. And finally, the last part of the particles world, SIM file, is constitute about the parameter value, and this parameter variable are the range of your model parameters. So as we already have seen, we have three parameters: range, nugget, and seal. And as we were saying, we fix for each of these parameters, we fix the lower and upper boundary. So, and which value we assign, those values are fixed according to your data. So before we were analyzing with Nicolò that the range, for example, would be around 5,000. So we fix, in this case, this extreme, lower and upper, and the same things for the nugget and the seal. Here, they are a little bit bigger, let's say, but those parameters can be modified according to your needs. Finally, there is the very last section of your particle world and SIM file, which is the objective function. The objective function we already have seen this morning. We have many implemented inside OMS. Here we are using the root mean square error, and then we have to tell him what are the simulated variables and what are the observed variables. And here we specify that the simulated comes from the model that we are calibrating, and this is the theoretical variogram. And the observed are the observed semivariants. Okay, so the particle worm ends here. Before to move to the next Rose, do you have any question?
Could you please explain check underline last equal to?
Last, okay. So the first one is what is the last? The last number of simulations you want to run. So we run about 175 simulations as a minimum thing. And then you specify the last. So to see if we have reached the stopping criteria or not, how many of those simulations we will consider? So we will consider at least of these, this is 175. We want to consider at least the last 50 of those. And on this, we start to check the simulation, the stopping criteria. Why we run this at least this 170, but this is a user-defined parameter, so you can change it. Why we run this? Because we want to make sure that we start to see if we have a convergence. We want to make sure that we explored enough the our parameter space. Okay, so it means that before to say we arrived to the optimal, we want to make sure that we already had a look to our parameter space. Any other question? Okay. So, in this example, I also show you how to concatenate different things. So, up to now we just saw a simulation file. We didn't see before than this example, we never seen a particle swarm. Okay, now what we do? We run a particle swarm, and then the output of the particle swarm is the optimal parameter set of your simulation. So, are the value of range, sim, fill, and nugget that optimally fit your observed semivariance, experimental semivariance. Then what we do? We take this variable out of particle swarm and we run a model simulation. So I run again my theoretical variogram here. This is just this from here to down here. It's exactly what we have already seen before with Niccolò. It's just to run a theoretical variable simulation. What is the difference with respect to the previous one? What is the difference with respect to number two? The difference is that whereas before we were fixing our range, seal, and nugget to value that you wanted to try, for example, we tried the 50,000 and then we tried at 0.2 and then we put 0.22. I'll show you here. You see here we had this number, just our type, our trial. Whereas in the number three, the difference is that we are taking those values from the particle swarm we ran before. So those are the parameter optimum, the optimal parameters for our simulation. And then we just write our output, which is the theoretical semivariance computed with the optimal parameters. If you change on top of this, if you change your semivariogram type, then you will fit another type of semivariogram, let's say circular, and it will do all the job for you. And then you will print out your theoretical circular semivariance for your data. Mm-hmm. Is this clear? Any question? Yes?
A little. It's possible instead to copy and paste the piece of code of the
model
to call the two underscore TV underscore precipt sim?
No.
It's not possible. Ah, okay.
Yes. Because inside the PS you have to provide a model. Whereas the previous one is just a simulation.
Ah, okay.
So it's not the complete copy and paste of it. I'll show you. This one is the number 2.
Yeah.
Is defined as a simulation file.
Yes.
And you, what you will copy is just the model.
Okay.
From here to here.
Yeah.
And not all the simulation file. So you will copy just the model.
Okay.
And here is declared that dot sim, whereas here he knows that is another environment, is the particle swarm environment, and the model you want to calibrate, it has to be defined inside.
Oh, okay.
So the final parameters are not printed out somewhere.
Yes, they are, and you will see it on the console.
It's after the
when you run, when it ends, you will see it here. Okay, but there is another question. What we are doing here is a very simple thing. So it's just fit a linear, a nonlinear function to data, no? So you don't have to use a particle swarm to do that. There are many other optimization, not optimization, minimization routines that does that. The idea is to introduce it for you just to put another one more ingredient on top of this, which is the heuristic algorithm and the particle swarm. Otherwise, here minimum quadratic would have been more than enough to do that. Okay. But the idea was to show you how to calibrate a model. And this model can be a semi-variable, but could be a rental and off model or whatever you want. Is this clear? And probably least square would be the fastest, would be faster than the particle swarm, but here is the concept that we want to do, not the numerical method. Okay, then if all is clear, you can run the vertical swarm and hopefully it will work. You want?
Yeah, I got some more.
Do you all got?
Yeah, I got some more. The same. I got the same.
Okay.
Run.
Yes. Because did you run all the simulation of?
Yeah, I know, but not with total. With season.